crashed to the ground and was in hospital for many months. Ladies and gentlemen, we give you the world's number one escapologist, Shahid Malik. Now, as you can imagine, with any stunt, there is a lot of preparation work. Lisa, his wife, is with him. We have the crane driver in place. Just look at the height of that gym, ladies and gentlemen, because in not many, many minutes, that is exactly where Shahid is going to end up. He's not just going to end up there, just sitting there, or holding on. He's going to end up there, upside down, strapped by his ankles that are already chained together. He's going to be up there, upside down, strapped by his ankles, in a straitjacket. Number one escapologist here for you today at the 1997 Lord Mayor Show, Shahid Malik. It's quite critical at this stage that the crane is set up correct, that the jib is correct, the lines are right, and then every single bolt, every single hook, every bit of tension on wires, any hooks, padlocks, chains, will all be checked, double checked by Shahid and his wife Lisa himself. Okay, the crane is in place. The jib is now in place. The all important hook from the jib down to the protective plate that you see here is now being checked and double checked. Into place now and connected to the crane is a rope. It's a canvas. Have you ever hung upside down at 90 feet from a crane, Nigel?
No, thank you.
You don't know what, you've let your son happen. I'm only joking. What, Nigel, you are going to do, you're going to act as the scrutineer of this whole act. The buckles are all attached. Would you agree? Lisa, Shahid, two. You're a truck driver. Aren't you used to the straps at the side of the old lorries now?
I just thought that.
And last but not least, be very tight in the fight. It is the last one. He will tell you he did, and that's the truth. We're standing there right now. What do you think? That's the end of it then. He then ties his ankles together. I think you're off with anything at the moment. Are you ready? Very tight those ankle straps now, go around. Once he does that, while he's trying to do all of that, ladies and gentlemen, that rope that you see will be on fire. It has a burn time of approximately 3 to 4 minutes maximum. If Shahid, for any reason, we've already told you live on BBC television, he did fail the once, does not get himself out, first of all, out of the straitjacket in time, he'll drop from a height of 90 feet. If he succeeds in doing that, but fails to right himself, at 30 feet and that burns through, that's far enough to fall to do yourself some serious damage. Lisa, light that rope. As you can now see, that rope is on fire. It is burning well, it is burning fast. Shahid will then give the signal to the driver to take him up. 19 feet in the air above Canon Hill Park, ladies and gentlemen. You're about to see an incredible death-defying feat. Remember, we have no stopwatch. We haven't started one. Shahid obviously has no idea of the time, if he had one in his pocket. All he does know is he has about 3.5 minutes to get himself back on the ground before that rope burns through. One downside to it all that you might see is unfortunately parts of the rope start to burn off and hit him. Yesterday, a nasty burn to the face where one part hit him, but that can catch fire on any part of that straitjacket. Certainly seems to be taking a lot longer than it did yesterday. A lot longer. The arms round. That's only the start of it, don't forget. Can you see one hand free there? Remember, he's now going to undo all those straps that Nigel put on the very last hole of the buckle. You can see that rope burning, ladies and gentlemen. You can see large chunks of it already falling off. And that's only the start of it. Single. First of all to the crane driver, that's not the end, don't forget. He is now going to come down to a height of 30 feet and now right himself, get the ankle straps off and round before he'll be lowered completely to the ground. Lisa signals, stop the crane. Bear in mind, he's been up there upside down for the last couple of minutes or so. The strength and the agility that is needed to get that strap off. Every jerk on that rope can make things worse.
Again, with the crane, with Lisa, his wife, for an even more death-defying act.